Welcome back to Mandurah, Western Australia. We rejoin Matt Crowhurst for the finals.
Oh, she's got calm out there.
Mr. Powers is quite right. The conditions have flattened off just that little bit, which is a little unfair on the ladies, but that bit better for our pro men's final here of this World Cup in Western Australia. Will Marc Kroon, our first rider of the dock representing Europe from the Netherlands, be able to make use of the slightly flatter conditions? Let's wait and see. Coming in for his very first hit of that huge X-Star wake and fully making use of it, launching himself skyward with an Indy Clyde to get things going. Now in on his toe side edge, going from invert to spin. That is a toe side, front side, off axis 540. Popping it back round to right foot forward so we can attack the wake on his heel side, the easier way of approaching the wake, and that is a Moby Dick. No messing around from Mr. Kroon. The Dutchman trying to pack in four tricks before the rail. A little bit of a stutter coming on his toe side edge. Oh, and casing the knuckle of the incline on the rail, which was definitely what put him off balance. See that little crack there, pushing him over the front of the board and then landing on the far side of the obstacle relative to the boat, making it very difficult indeed to ride away. So still a good first run from Mark. No problem with the ollie on that time. Backside board slide, then a little hop to bat lick, then a back 90 degree rotation out. Toe side edge now for a bat wing. He's already got a whole bunch of technical maneuvers in that first pass. Can he keep racking them up? Then going for the 900 and booting it so large off the wake. That is 2.5 rotations and going for the same again, back the other way. That is incredible stuff from Marc Kroon. Going from 900 to switch 900 off his toe side edge. That is putting the pressure on the rest of the riders to follow, but if anybody can get ahead of the game, it is this lad, Daniel Powers. Found himself on the podium before at World Cup, former world champion in the junior men's division. He is no stranger to big, big events, and we see that from these tricks already, not worrying about the conditions whatsoever. Chromo right there at the end in slow motion. Oh, going for the backside by 40, making it a 360 because he got booted out the front a little bit, and then a beautiful rail ride hits. So while the first pass was clean, there was one little stutter where he went for a trick and didn't quite come up with what he was after. Now coming in toe side for a front side board slide and then passing the handle to do a 90 out, popping it back round to left foot board, which is Daniel's more comfortable way of riding. See that solid white knuckle grab of the board with a backside 180 on the end of that tantrum, so smoothly done. On his toe side now, and then just about getting away from that super hucked toe side, front side 720, then making the handle pass and also just about scraping away the KGB, the bat roll with the backside 360, and then getting really, really aggressive with that dum-dum roll, which we saw from Marc Kroon as well, and absolutely whipping that heel side, front side 720 round. That ended up being a very, very good run for Daniel Powers as he cruises back into the dock with a clean, dry hair finish.
Dude, it feels like glass out there. Looks like
as we pass the baton on to our next rider, it's Mr. Andrew Adkison.
Nice ride, dude.
Of all the riders in this entire contest, and especially in this final, Andrew is the man with the most World Cup experience. He can pull it out in any conditions. Can he do the same again here? Getting some serious boot off that X-Star wake for his very first trick, and Moby Dick getting a late method grab on that as well. And then another late little tickle of the board on that Tootsie Roll. Quick adjust of the lid as he moves into his next trick. So far, we have seen full technical maneuvers. That's inverts with handle pass rotations and then a grab on every single one. And then just to mix up those composition points, adding the front side 720 in on the end. Then we've got, oh, and a beautiful slow motion of the Whirly Bird. That is that backflip with an Ole rotation, full 360 Ole rotation, and there's nobody who does them better than Andrew, making that first pass one of the best we've seen at this event. So incredible stuff from Andrew Atkinson. Front side lip slide, and then rotating a 270 off the end there, so a solid rail ride to start off his second pass. Then he goes for the off-axis 540, getting that board right up above his head, fully crunched up through the air, making it look very smooth indeed. Is this going to be the Crow 5? Yes, it is. So it's the front roll with the 540-degree rotation, the first 540-degree invert we've seen so far. Then the heel side 7, just about getting away with it, right over the nose of the board, muscles it away. Toe side, Pete Rose, oh! And then, just for his efforts, a rather heavy stack. Notice how he doesn't get the height, doesn't get the board underneath him, catching the edge right there. Let's hope he's okay. Could have been a little bit of a knee tweaker, but that is still some very, very good riding.
I'm on wakeboard right now.
A as we move on to our next rider in this final of the Pro Men's, Mr. Parker Siegelle. Beautiful steez on that heelside, frontside 360, getting a little poke on the end of it as he pops it back round to left foot forward. Going for the whirly bird, whipping that handle across his face, almost an uppercut to make that rotation happen. Coming back on his toe side edge now, getting some serious edge tripping into that tootsie roll, making it look very smooth indeed. Still not massive height, but a clean trick. Oh, wow, and a Moby Dick 5. We have not seen one of those yet. So that is the handle pass in the middle of that backside rotation through the tantrum, and then an extra 180 on the end of it to make it a 540 right at the end of his second run. So no time wasted. He's still got a pretty full pass. Backside board slide on to the rail to start things off. Oh, getting overcooked a little bit off axis, but muscles it through on that 720. Coming back on his toe side edge now. Missing the grab a little bit, but getting a good solid chrome over that. So that's a toe side front roll with a full 360. Parker now getting to the end of this second pass. Getting the grab on the Indy tantrum with a backside 180 on as well. Cleanly done, smoothly down the transition of that X-Star wake. Then the off-axis 720 of his toe side edge, whipping the handle, getting good control of that handle to ride it away smoothly as we see Shota and Harley Clifford looking on. And we move on to our last couple of riders in this final. It's Shota Tezuka of Japan, rookie of the year last year. Sorry, not rookie of the year. What am I on about? Because he's full-blown pro. He had the trick of the year as voted for by wakeboard fans across the world, and he deserves it. And you can see why that he might come up with such a maneuver with a booted KGB going skyward like we saw just then. Off axis, toe side, backside 180 with a late grab, just about getting the board underneath him. Pops it back round to left foot forward for a heelside hit of that X-Star wake. Getting the handle pass on the Moby Dick, going for the late grab as he rotates that, finishes that 360 off onto the rail for a back lip. Finishing off that backside 360 with a very, very clean hit all round. So maybe a little bit of a wobble on that one maneuver, but still an awesome first pass from Shota. Not the rail hit he was after, a 180 onto 50-50, rides it away, left foot forward, now coming in with that super smooth approach, and you don't get any better heel side 720s than that. Lots of height, clean landing, nice and tucked up. Now we see the 900, loads of height once again, dropping out of the sky. Not a butt check in sight from Shota. Then the toe side, oh, the fat chance five. Not the fat chance, because it was with his left foot forward, which is his more comfortable foot forward. That is the front mob five. So the second of our 540 tricks. And then another one straight after that, the crow five. So already he is upping the ante and piling the pressure on the last rider in this finals, Harley Clifford. Wow, insane riding so far. And it just gets more breathtaking every single stop of the World Cup, year on, year out. And here we round things up in Mandurah with the wakeboard final. And wouldn't it be nice to see this man, as far as the Australian crowd is concerned, on the top of that podium. It's not as if it would be his first time. Australian born, homegrown talent, Harley Clifford comes in for his first hit. Big, big front move. Starting left foot forward, throwing the front flip and the rotating full front side 360 throughout that trick. Then getting the nose side, nose grab, toe side back roll with a backside 180 on, having to pass the handle to make that happen. There we see the handle pass for the Moby Dick with a late grab on the end of it. You see the couple of extra feet in the air that Harley gets versus the rest of the riders. That time just makes it look so much smoother and means that every single landing is as smooth as can be. Tail grab, back roll to blind, unfortunately missing the rail right at the end there. Symptomatic of the fact that he goes so big, using up all of the time in that first run. So here we go. This is the last time that the X-Star will pass in front of the crowd. Going this way, starting off his run with a frontside board slide, coming off a little bit early with a 90 degree rotation on the end. Left foot forward for Harley as he gets all hooked up on that backside seven, squeezing the board back underneath him as he almost gets stretches out off the board. Then we see the 900. Straight back after that 720, so two huge spins from him, and then another 720 coming back at the wake. So we saw toe side seven, toe side nine, then back into heel side seven, and it's hard for me to even keep up with all of the maneuvers. Then we got the KGB, then just as the boat starts to turn, I'm not sure whether that will count, but it's an Indy tantrum to blind to finish for Harley Clifford, and you would struggle to find a pair of contest runs better than that. But it is going to be so tight between Harley and Shota Tezuka of Japan. We can only wait and see.
So impressive rides for both Harley Clifford and Shota Tezuka. Harley just clinching that top spot, and yet another title for Australia.
Yeah, definitely a tight win. Shota went out there and killed it, and then I went out there and did pretty good, but I actually came back to the dock and I was like, whoa! I didn't even realize I didn't do like three of the tricks I was supposed to do because I was like just in such a rush and stuff. But no, super stoked to get the win. It's such a good start of the season, two wins back to back, and it's always cool to win events in Australia, especially when like the Australian crowd's here and they're all like, yeah, go Australia, go Australia. So yeah, it's been an awesome weekend. You know, coming down to Mandurah is always fun. Such a beautiful place, and can't wait to come back for the next 2 years. I love it.
An amazing event. Once again, if you've enjoyed what you've seen, we've got plenty more action still to come through the season. Next, we move on to Palembang in Indonesia for stop 37. We hope you'll join us for that.